so far away. As a child, father would tell me stories.
Pay attention. Something's happening down there.
Is that? It's the Vizier. He has been completely transformed.
Interesting. He has used the power of the sands to transform his army. And these artifacts will allow him to transport them across the city with ease. He appears to be in complete control. Things do not look too good for you at the moment.
I will not let the Vizier have Babylon. My city. My throne. He has used that beam as a gate. We will follow him through it.
Well, that certainly went according to plan, did it not? You really should know by now that entering portals made of sand only leads to trouble.
I will simply have to resort to a more traditional form of transport.
Hopefully with greater success.
Separate them into two groups. Send the weak ones to the working army. The strong ones to the palace and arena for changing.
Somebody, help us!
Thank you.
Wonderful. Do we not have enough to deal with already?
That chariot should get us home.
Are you sure you can control this thing?
More, the prince began the journey home, his mind afire with visions of the justice he would visit upon the vizier.
Be vigilant. Done well, Prince. Though I'm sure it is not intentional. Watch out! That was close. Behind that column.
The once bright and vibrant streets of Babylon now stood all but deserted, its inhabitants either dead or fled. Those left behind suffered terribly, captured, tortured, and transformed. But the prince did not notice this. So focused was he on the vizier.
I'm impressed.
Oh, good. Your opinion means a great deal to me.
Is that how you thank the man who just saved your life?
First, you did not save my life. I did. Second, you are not a man. Just a disembodied voice. A ghost. And third, I never asked for your help, and I certainly do not need it.
While I admire your bravado, you would be wise to show some respect.
And you would be wise to keep quiet. You are distracting me, and we are no longer alone.